Good morning, students. In the last class, we discussed about the switching system and the switching network. Switching network means establishing a connection between calling and call subscriber with the help of switching hierarchy. Okay. After that, we discussed about the communication links, that is electrical communication link and optical communication link, which are used for intercity connection, transcontinental connection and intercontinental connection. Later, we discussed about a simple telephone circuit, right? What is a simple telephone circuit? Which is used for one-way communication. That means, when A is speaking, B has to listen. B cannot speak. That is called as one-way communication. In this circuit, totally four components are there, right? Microphone, earphone, inductor and a battery source. In the last class, we discussed about the operation of carbon microphone and came to one conclusion that this carbon microphone undergoes amplitude modulation. That means it acts like an amplitude modulator, right? In this class, we discuss the derivation. So theoretically, we proved that this carbon microphone acts like an amplitude modulator. Now in this class, we'll discuss and we'll prove that mathematically. Okay. So here, what is RI? RI is called as instantaneous resistance. We know that this carbon microphone operates on the principle of change in resistance. That means whenever the carbon granules are closely packed, the resistance increases. Whenever the carbon granules are loosely packed, the resistance increases. Okay. Therefore, I can write as RI. What is RI? RI is called as instantaneous resistance and R0 is called as resistance before applying any voice signal. This is the resistance after applying the voice signal. Why I am taking here sign? We know that generally we represent analog signals in terms of sine or cosine, right? Here I am taking sine. Generally, we represent any analog signal in terms of sine or cosine property. I am taking here a sine term here. Why minus here? Why minus means because whenever sound is applied, the resistance decreases. The decremental resistance is shown with the help of this minus here. Okay. This is the formula of instantaneous resistance. Now, how to find instantaneous current? Ii is equal to V by Ra. Right. We know that current is equal to voltage by resistance. Okay. You can take the height A. So, what is Ra? Ra is nothing but R0 minus R sin omega t. Simplify this. What will get? Take R common here. What will get? M is equal to nothing but R by R naught. Since R is more than R, always the value of M is less than 1. Always the value of M is less than 1. We know that this expression is in the form of 1 minus x whole power minus 1. We can apply binomial expansion here to expand this. Since to apply binomial expansion, what is the condition? Always x is less than 1. This is the condition for to apply binomial expansion. In this case, m is less than 1. Therefore, I can apply binomial expansion for this. If you apply this, what is the formula here? 1 plus x square plus and so on. Since m is small, the square of m is very very small. Therefore, we can neglect the higher order terms. Therefore, this is the final expression. This expression is similar to the amplitude modulated wave. Therefore, we can say that this microphone acts like an amplitude modulator, where m is called as modulation index. Okay. This is the mathematical derivation to prove that microphone acts like an amplitude modulator. Okay. And one more point here is, this I naught is called as what? Quiescent current or bias current. For example, if I naught is equal to 0, what happens? II becomes 0. That means it will not do any modulation. That means microphone will not convert that voice to an current pulse. Okay. Therefore, this quiescent current is very much required for the operation of a microphone. Generally, microphone requires 23 to 25 milliamperes of current for proper operation of microphone. This current is provided from voltage source battery. Okay. This is about the operation of the microphone and its mathematical derivation for amplitude modulation. Next one is inductor. The next component in circuit is inductor. We know that the inductor offers high impedance for AC and allows DC. Okay. That's the property of a inductor. The necessity of using this inductor is, what is this output? The output of the microphone is voice current. Nothing but what? Amplitude modulated current. This is analog. But to provide this analog output, it requires a DC current. Nothing but this is I naught. This battery is going to provide the quiescent current I naught. This inductor is going to allow this DC current to the microphone as well as to the earphone. Whereas this inductor offers high impedance for this voice current. Therefore, it will pass only through the earphone. Clear? That is the main reason why we are using a inductor here and a battery source here. And what is the last component? That is earphone. What is the earphone? Earphone is a transducer which converts electrical signal to a voice. Converts electrical to voice signal. Okay. The earphone what we are using in telephone set is an electromagnet with a magnetic diaphragm. Okay. Electromagnet with a magnetic diaphragm. Now see the circuit of earphone. So this is a circuit of earphone which contains, you can see they are saying here it has a permanent magnet, right? So this is a permanent magnet. But in our circuit, we use electromagnet. In place of permanent magnet, we use electromagnet. Because from the voltage source, we are getting the bias current, right? That bias current is sufficient to operate this earphone. And the voice current coming from microphone is passed through the electromagnets. Through these two electromagnets. So it is passed from here to and receiving here. Okay. So therefore it behaves like an electromagnet with north and south poles here. Okay, so before discussing the operation, in EMTL we studied some concepts. That is, whenever a conductor carries current, it is going to produce flux, right? Whenever a conductor carries current, it is going to create some flux, phi. If current is DC, it is going to produce a constant flux. If current is time varying, it is going to produce time varying flux. Right? Okay. Now, this is a permanent magnet. This is an electromagnet with a DC bias. So, this is going to produce a constant flux phi naught. Whereas, these electromagnets are going to produce time varying flux. Clear? And one more point is, whenever a conductor placed in magnetic field, what happens? It experiences some force, right? This force is proportional to square of the flux. Whenever a conductor placed in magnetic field, it experiences some force. That force is proportional to the square of the flux. That is the operation behind the earphone. So whenever we apply this voice current, it is going to create some alternating or variable force. That variable force will vibrate the diaphragm, magnetic diaphragm. Therefore, according to the voice current, it is going to produce the output audio signal, which is same as the audio signal input per microphone. So this is the operation of your earphone. Okay. The basic principle is the applied force is proportional to the square of the flux. If you observe the final expression, here you can see that this force is proportional to the input voice current to the earphone. Okay. Now, the next one is half duplex telephone communication. What is the meaning of half duplex telephone communication? It is nothing but here both, in both the direction communication is possible, but only one at a time. That means if A is speaking, then B has to listen. Clear? When A is speaking, B has to listen. He cannot talk back. When B is talking or speaking, A has to listen. Got the point? This is called as half duplex communication. Okay. So the circuit is same as simplex, but here you provided earphones and microphones for both the subscribers. Now, coming to the explanation. Here, so whenever A is speaking, what is the operation of microphone? It is going to convert the audio into voice current. So it is going to produce a voice current, right? This voice current is propagated to the earphone of B subscriber as well as A's own earphone. Clear? This voice current is propagated because path is available. This voice current is passed through the earphone of B subscriber as well as earphone of A subscriber. Here, A is listening his own voice. Therefore, this voice is called as side tone. What is side tone? Audio signal heard by the self earphone is called as side tone. Audio signal heard by the self earphone is called as side tone. So here, for A, he is listening his own voice. Therefore, this voice is called as side tone. Whether this side tone is required or not, is side tone is necessary or not. For example, whenever I want to communicate some information to a person, in that case, I put some cotton in my ears. Now I am trying to call the second person. In that case, what happens? I don't know whether the voice is audible to him. So that what I will do? I am going to shout. That means, if no side tone, user tends to shout. Clear? So, some side tone is required to us also for proper communication. Okay? So, in that scenario, we are going to design a half duplex circuit with a side tone. This is circuit of a half duplex with a side tone. So, before discuss the operation of this one, we already know that inductor principles, series aiding and series opposing. What is series aiding and what is series opposing? Based on the sense of winding, if two fluxes are adding, then we can say that the two inductors are in series aiding connection. If the fluxes is subtracting, then you can say that these two inductors are in series opposition connection. Now, case 1. Now again A is speaking. Therefore, this is going to produce an voice current. Right? This voice current is transmitted to both the P and Q windings. Right? But the direction is opposite. Therefore, in this case, P and Q acts like a series opposite. Okay, in this case, the P and Q windings behaves like a series opposing inductors. Therefore, what happens? The resultant flux is reduced. Therefore, a fraction of flux is coupled to the second winding. Therefore, the intensity of your signal is reduced. Therefore, the intensity of audio is less. Here A's own voice is heard by the A itself but with less intensity. Therefore, this is called as side tone. In the previous case, the entire intensity is heard by the A's earphone, which is not desired. But in this case, because of this binding connections, we are going to get a less intensity audio for the A's earphone. Okay. But whenever B is speaking, this is connection of B. When B is speaking, then what happens? The current, this voice current is same direction for both P and Q windings. Then what happens? Now these two windings are in series AD connection. Therefore, the resultant flux is phi 1 plus phi 2. That means the total speech intensity is reached to the earphone of A. Okay, total speech intensity is reached to the earphone of A. Okay, this is the operation of full duplex circuit with the side tones. Therefore, side tone is required but with less intensity. To get the less intensity, we are using this connection. Okay. Next one is basics of switching system. Okay. A major component of switching system is set of inputs and outputs called as inlets and outlets. If you take any switching system, it contains some inlets, inputs, as well as it contains some outputs. Okay, based upon the connection, we call them as inlets and outlets. Okay, inlets and outlets. The primary function of any switching system is to establish an electrical path between inlet to the outlet. Okay, the primary function of switching system is to establish an electrical path between inlet and outlet. Okay, switching configurations. So this is nothing but a model of a switch. Here, how the inlets and outlets are connected with respect to the exchanges as well as with respect to the own exchange. Folded switch and non-folded switches. Now see. So this is one switching network where A, B, C are the subscribers and here D, E, F are the subscribers. So to establish connection between this subscriber to these subscribers, we are using some switching elements or switching systems. So here in this case, it contains three inlets and only one outlet, right? That means the number of inlets and outlets may not be same. Okay, it may differ. So in this case, for this switching system, these lines are called as subscriber inlets. Already I said, right? For a given switching system, it contains some inputs and outputs, circuits which are called as inlets and outlets. These inlets are called as subscriber inlets, because for these inlets the subscribers are connected. Got the point? Here these outlets are called as subscriber outlets. For this exchange we call these outlets as subscriber outlets, because to the output the subscribers are connected. Okay, now coming to this switching system, this inlet is called as inlet trunk inlet, called as trunk inlet, and these outlets are called as trunk outlets. So try to remember the terminology. The wires are same, but the place which you are using differs the name. If the inlets are connected to the subscribers, they are called as inlet subscribers. If outlets are connected to the subscribers, they are called as outlet subscribers. If inlets are connected to the another exchange, they are called as trunk inlets. And the outlets are connected to the other exchanges, they are called as trunk outlets. Clear with the technology? Nice. So this is a model of a switch. So the objective of a switch is to establish a connection between an inlet and outlet pair temporarily. It is not permanent connection, it is a temporary connection. Okay, whenever the call is terminated, you have to relax this connection. Okay, therefore this is a temporary electrical connection between inlet and outlet. This switch may be a Strausser switch, a crossbar switch, or an electronic switch. But the objective is to establish an electrical path between inlet and outlets. Okay. So in this case, this exchange, or been called as a switching matrix. So this name is differently used in different contexts. This is not that switching network what we studied in the previous class. Nothing but the hierarchy of the switching elements. Not like that. The switching network means, here it is called as switching network is used to denote the switching hardware inside the switching system. In this scenario, in this context, you can call this as a switching hardware inside the switching system. Okay, if you observe here, both the subscribers as well as other exchanges, this is what other exchanges, are connected to a given network, to a given switching exchange. Therefore, in this case, you can see the subscriber lines as well as incoming trunks, outgoing trunks, as well as subscriber lines. Okay. So, folded switch. So, when this type of switch is required is, so for this exchange, A, B, and C are called as subscriber lines. We can call it as a local exchange. So for these subscribers, you can treat this switching system as local exchange. In this case, if A want to make a call to, if A want to make a call to C, how this is possible? This is possible only when the outlets are connected to the inlets. That is called as folded network. In case of folded network, okay, the outlets are connected to the inlets. Then only it is possible to establish a connection for these local subscribers 1, 2, 3 and so on n. So without this folded connection, it is not possible to make a call in between the subscribers. So one cannot make call to 2, or one cannot make call to n. Got the point? That's the advantage of using a folded switch. Non-folded switch. In all the cases, okay, the subscriber may not be connected to the exchange. Any exchange that does not support local subscribers is called as a transit exchange. Non-folded switch is an example for transit exchange. You see, right? here subscribers are not connected, only the exchanges are connected to this switch. Therefore, this type of switch is called as a folded switch. So, non-folded switch. Okay, in this case, subscribers are not, no local subscribers are present, only the exchanges are connected. This type of switch is called as a non-folded switch. Thank you.